it's time to blow this scene. Get everybody in the stuff together. Okay, 3, 2, 1, let's jam.
Dave and I were just talking, how do you convince people who live inland, who never come near an ocean, that what happens here impacts them directly?
It's amazing. More than 9 out of 10 of these birds have plastics in them.
Researchers think they've found a way to determine just how much of the mercury in the fish you're eating actually comes from nature.
NOAA scientists found evidence that suggests diseases in dolphins closely resemble those in humans. This could shed light on how humans
truly
are affected by
contaminated
water.
And
lighters here, golf ball, children's toy, toothbrush. It's amazing to think all this stuff was dropped
up on our dinner
and
plate.
Then eaten.
If we don't become proper stewards to our planet, and more specifically to our oceans, which seem so far away, we're not going to have any of those things.
An increased population has led to an overwhelming strain on our oceans. With global numbers topping over 6.5 billion, the problem of where to put all of our waste has begun to build up. Madalena Beazzi, president of the Ocean Conservation Society, has seen all too much of this firsthand.
Growing population is one of the biggest problems humanity is facing today. We are almost reaching 7 billion people, and we have limited resources. So high demand of fish, it's one of the big problems that we have, obviously, because there is not enough fish anymore to feed everybody.
Biomagnification refers to the increasing concentration of substances, such as toxic chemicals, in the tissues of organisms at successively higher levels of the food chain. As a result, organisms at the top of the food chain generally suffer greater harm from constant exposure to toxins or pollutants than those at the lower levels.
So if you look at the food chain and if you look at the base of the food chain, in the ocean you have small organisms, you have phytoplankton, zooplankton, shrimp, fish, bigger fish, and the top you have dolphins. Dolphins are top predators. They live at the top of the food chain. So these animals eat fish, that they eat smaller fish, that they eat shrimp, and these substances that start at the base of the food chain tend to accumulate more and more as you go up on the food chain. So animal like dolphin has a really high accumulation of these contaminants, and this is really bad for them, and we are seeing the effect today. And they're bad for us too, that we eat fish. It's pretty high in the food chain as well.
Biomagnification has serious consequences for all species. It is particularly dangerous for predator species at the top of long food webs. Those predators are at risk because the degree of biomagnification is high by the time it reaches their trophic level. Also, top predators usually consume large quantities of meat, which have lots of fatty tissue and contaminants. Polar bears, humans, eagles, and dolphins are examples of top predators, and all of these organisms are vulnerable to the effects of biomagnification.
Pollution is another huge issue. You have overfishing, you have pollution, you have coastal overdevelopment, pollutions. You know, we think the ocean are this infinite space. It's an infinite space where we can throw everything in it. We use as a dump for so many years, and now these pollutants that we threw in the ocean are getting back to us. So they are not only present in all the living creatures in the ocean, but also present in our body because we eat some of these pollutants. So we have toxins, we have mercury. If you go by fish in the market, they say pregnant woman don't eat this fish because of high concentration of mercury. We have PCB, we have still even DDT in the water. The fish are still accumulating even if DDT disappeared many years ago.
Dolphins serve as the ambassadors of our oceans. On display in aquariums and as the vehicles of entertainment behind multi-billion dollar corporations, dolphins, like humans, are at the top of the food chain. However, being at the top has its price. Ingesting large quantities of foreign matter and contaminated fish, dolphins accumulate high levels of mercury into their bloodstream from their food. Like dolphins, we consume large quantities of fish from the ocean, the same ocean that we are infecting.
I think it's more of a show. You need to think that these aquaria are multi-million dollar businesses. If you study dolphins and whales in the field like I did for over 20 years,
and you see these animals in their own environment, you understand their anxiety in which they live, you understand that they have bonds,
the mother and calf can stay together for over 2 years. If you understand all these things, and it's difficult for me to say yes, it's right to keep animal in captivity. These animals have large movements, need space. An aquarium can't provide this type of thing. So it's completely wrong to keep this type of animal in captivity.
Continued efforts to keep dolphins in captivity and out of their natural environment leads us down a path of continued abuse of our oceans and exploitation of possibly one of our greatest natural educators. By emphasizing the importance of dolphins in the wild, we can learn about ourselves. Diseases, societal structure, and even our cognitive skills can be better understood by observing such creatures in their natural habitat.
There are some instances where they can be kept for a short time, like injured dolphins, but they should be released afterwards. Or we are pushing some of these species to the brink of extinction, so maybe in some cases for breeding you can take some of these animals in captivity, but these are the only exceptions. I don't think a person that goes to an aquarium really learn about these animals, because they don't see what these animals really is. If you go out and see a dolphin in the wild, and then you go to an aquarium and see how an aquarium, you see how these dolphins behave in captivity, they behave in a completely different way. So what do you learn?
The oceans stand as our closest and most foreign frontier, giving rise to a bounty of life and resources we neglect and take for granted.
If we do not try to conserve the oceans, we threaten valuable food supplies, vital natural resources, and the delicate balance of life.
Through awareness and education, we can begin to take action.
Through our compassion, we can make the difference.
I think we should be better citizens. I think we should be active and more informed citizen. Education is a huge problem we have today, not only environmental education, but education as a whole. So I think people need to understand the problems a little bit better, and only understanding the problem you can start to resolve the problems.